Welcome to the GameMaker Studio 2 start page. Right here we have Create New Project. We can start either a drag and drop one or a GameMaker language one. I'm going to be focusing primarily on GameMaker language. This is a built-in language for GameMaker Studio, and it's similar to languages like JavaScript. On the left side, we have recent projects. This is where any projects you've had opened recently, you'll be able to click on and open up again. At the top, we've got some social buttons. This one will bring you to the Yo-Yo Games website. This one will bring you to their Facebook page, their YouTube page, and their Twitter page. Over here is a button that will lead you to the home page, which brings you to Getting Started, where you can start a new project, open a project you've made before, or import one from GameMaker Studio 1.4. I'll have more on that later. You can also explore the marketplace, tutorials, and demos. If you click on one of these buttons, it'll bring you to this page of officially created tutorials. And if we hit the back button, we can go to demos, once again bringing you to the official demos. You'll have to download them to use them, and then you can open up the projects right here on the one where it says owned. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to start a new project. And we're going to start a GameMaker language project. Once you've named your new project, GameMaker Studio will open up the workspace in the Interactive Development Environment, or IDE. At the top we have some menus, and below that we have some quick buttons. Down here will be your workspace. Up here you'll see the version of the IDE and runtime. This is also where you have notifications. And below is your target module. This is where you can select where your outputs would be, either to Windows, Mac, Ubuntu, and later ones as they come out. You can select whether you're going to use VM or YYC for your output. And your device and configuration are your own setup. These are default, and you can make your own later. Below that, we have the resource tree. This has your sprites, tile sets, sounds, paths, scripts, shaders, fonts, timelines, objects, rooms, notes, included files, extensions, options, and configurations. The first menu is File. Inside, you can create a new project. You can open an existing project. You can import a project from GameMaker 1.4. You can find your recently opened projects. You can save the current project. You can save the current project as a new project. You can export the project as a standalone file. You can open up your preferences, more on that later. You can check out your account page on the Yo-Yo Games website. You can log out of GameMaker Studio 2, and you can completely close the software. The second menu is the Edit menu. Here you can undo and redo, and you can also search and replace. This will open up a dialog box for search and replace, where you can search through your code for a specific word and replace it with something else. You can use case sensitivity, you can search whole word only, you can find all, find previous, next, replace all, and just replace this single one. The next menu is the Windows menu. Here you can open up your resource tree, your output window, your search results window, your source control output, your breakpoints, compile errors, syntax errors, and IDE environment variables, as well as your tutorial windows. Your resource window is typically open by default, but you can open up another one like that. All of these other ones are at the bottom here, your output, your search results, your source control, breakpoints, compile errors, and syntax errors. It sounds complicated now, but we'll get into it later. Down here is a button for show and hide the bottom windows. I'm going to do that to collapse those. There's also one on the right side for anything docked on the right, and there will be one on the left for when I have something docked on the left. The next menu is the Tools menu. Here you can open up your texture groups, your audio groups, your sound mixer, and your generate project images. Each one I'll go into more detail later, but this is where you can find them in the menus. The next menu option is Marketplace. Here you can open up the marketplace. You can go to your library of previously downloaded items from the marketplace. You can check out your purchase history of items you've purchased from the marketplace. Here you can create and update your own marketplace item or package in this case. If I click on Open Marketplace, I'll get a new window inside the workspace area, and I'll be taken to the marketplace website. This is where you can browse assets generated by other users and Yo-Yo games themselves. You can also go to your own library and see the ones you've previously downloaded and install them from here, or download again, or view in the marketplace, whatever you need to do with the ones you've already downloaded. The next menu item is Help. Inside, you can go to the Start page for Game Maker Studio 2, the Welcome page. You can also open up the manual to learn more about how to use Game Maker Studio. You can open up the Knowledge Base, report a bug, go to the Yo-Yo Games website, go to the Game Maker Community website, look at the release notes of the current build you're using. You can look at the current runtime release notes, and you can look at the required SDKs for Game Maker Studio 2. You can also open the project you currently have open in Explorer, check out the licenses for Game Maker Studio 2, and click on About to read more information about the current build of Game Maker Studio you have open. The last menu item is Layouts. Here you can save your current layout to somewhere on your computer, load a layout from somewhere on your computer, or reset the current layout back to its original setting. To change your layout, all you need to do is grab these tabs and drag them somewhere else. You can resize these windows, place them anywhere on your desktop you like it to be, or you can dock it on the left, the right, or bottom edges of the screen. By default, the resources are on the right. These are all at the bottom, and typically your room options will open up on the left side whenever you open a room to edit. If you'd like to rename the Workspace tab, all you have to do is double-click on it and call it whatever you like. You can also add more tabs by hitting the plus icon next to any existing tab. The last thing I'd like to talk about are the quick buttons. The first one sends you back to the home page. The next one creates a new project. Next to that, you can open a project, and next to that, you can save a project. You can also see the shortcut keys next to the names of each button. The next button will create an executable for the project you currently have open. This is the way of finalizing your game for someone else to open and play. The next button will allow you to run and test your game in debug mode. The button next to that will run and test the game not in debug mode. The next button will stop compiling a game or stop a game that is currently running that you're testing. The next button will clean your cache. This is a good thing to do before compiling your final game, as some things are holdovers or just clutter up the cache. You want the cleanest version of your build before you release it. The button after that will open up game options. More on that later. The one next to it will open up the help file. This is a great way to learn a lot about Game Maker Studio 2. And the last buttons have to do with the workspace itself. When you have something open, like this window here, I can scroll through my workspace, and with this button I can zoom out on my workspace. This one zooms into the workspace. The one in between with the equal sign will reset the view back to 100%. And the final button will collapse any of the panels I have open, and then put them back to their original state by clicking on it again. And with that, you have a basic understanding of the Game Maker Studio 2 interface.